Earl Simmons, best known as DMX, was a Grammy-nominated rapper. His distinctive and raspy voice propelled him to the top of music charts through the late 90s and early 2000s. He was a leader of the popular group, the Ruffriders, known for their affinity of motorcycles, music, and dogs. DMX was the first and only rapper to have his first five albums consecutively debut at number one on Billboard. But his successful music career was riddled with arrests and drug abuse, stemming from what he says was a childhood of abuse and betrayal. Born in Mount Vernon, New York in 1970, DMX and his family moved to Yonkers for more affordable housing when he was a child. Trouble started early. He spent much of his youth in and out of group homes and juvenile centers, he wrote, in an autobiography published in 2002. According to him, his first run-in with the law and detention came at just 7 years old. Among his nights in a juvenile detention center as a teen, DMX wrote he found a way to escape his troubled reality, music. In 1998, when the music world was still reeling from the death of two hip-hop greats, Tupac and Biggie, DMX blazed the scene, taking the reins as a hit-making MC. His first record, Get At Me, Dog, was certified gold. His first album debuted at number one on the Billboard Albums chart, selling 250,000 records in its first week. He even starred in blockbuster movies. While his acting and music earned him fame, DMX kept it real with fans about what his life was really like. A Christian, he often prayed before and during performances, in interviews, and on Instagram Live. He was vocal about his rough upbringing in his music and in interviews. In a 2020 interview on People's Party with Talib Kweli, he broke down as he recounted his introduction to drugs at 14.
I hit the blood, and I'm like, I was no longer focused on the money. I never felt like this. I later found out that he laced the blood with crack. Why would you do that to a child?
Never giving up hope, DMX wanted to be a better man. He sat down with GQ magazine in 2019, where he opened up about overcoming the abuse he suffered as a child. He entered into rehab, even sat down with Iyanla Van Zandt.
Do you have a drug problem now?
I will always have a drug problem.
Tell me about that.
Just because you stop getting high doesn't mean that you don't have the problem, because it's a constant fight every day.
But the controversial interview left DMX storming off set in a rage after being confronted about his drug abuse. While his story was troubled, he remained a man of faith, never giving up his quest to become better.
Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping.